Trades coming out.
Could be a 3v3 on bot.
Caria not going to be in range to help just yet. Ward comes down. Owner going to take the first half of the Q and going to get the shield now as well. FBI is exhausted. FBI has to flash back to safety. The follow through could be there, and it's first blood. Owner grabs it, ignited, but survives out of the turret.
And I just love that we saw exactly what Azale was talking about with the exhaust coming
down river with Closer. Dang. So could potentially be a 4v4 if Faker wants to join.
And we're going to have Sunday take a battle with Kana, maybe try to get him away from teleporting, but big damage. Kana could nearly tower dive him. Tidal Wave comes in. There's going to be a fight in the bottom side. No knockup really to be had. Gimayushi drops a bit low as the Lulu ult comes across. The flash follow, but he heals back up with the red ult. He closes still once in. Flash comes in, and they will get the rest of the damage. Finally, one kill on the board for 100 Thieves. Heralds
once again being the aggressors.
Oh, misses the chain again. Owner just sidestepping it, but maybe find a pillar. Keep in mind, Gimayushi.
He's available on Failure Chase.
Flashless.
Yeah, here
Caria
it is.
Going to flash the bubble, and here comes Faker. Here
They're
comes Owner for the stun. And that's going to be one easily. Kana looking for a bit more. Finds the second kill, a solo onto the Nami. Nowhere for the Trundle to go either. Closer has some stats for now. Ulti gonna land. That's gonna be a root on Abenaga as Owner shows up for kill number 3 and 4. It gets rid of a clone. Okay, fine. Just the 3 kills picked up. Someday.
FK down already. Looks like they want to try to force this Herald, but T1 are moving up to contest.
A slow one to Owner. A chance to knock down this Rift Herald for some damage onto a turret waiting for the eye to be popped. That won't quite be in Smite range. Smite fight, and it is going to Owner. Thank you very much for the leash.
Kana has flash ulti.
Yep. Finds a stun. Big damage to close and needs his ulti come off now, but it's already deletion. Who he is gone. The arrest of the bot lane already dead. Closer limping away with the split of the helm, but it's just everyone dying. Owner's on a killing spree. Faker spots it. Closer. Yeah, sorry, buddy. You are dying here as well. 4-0 on the fight, and T1 are slaughtering.
And overall, I feel like it's just been everything across the board for T1. Really nice early game pathing coming out from Owner. Nice early game plays. I love the draft overall. And the team fighting as well has been on point as Abenaga not going
to
get away.
Faker going to heal in for the gold card to get into range. Abenaga going to go for the guesswork. Sorry, buddy. This time they found it out, and that's going to be him dropping. So mid lane tier 2 also going to drop. Has now gone over to T1s. Okay, he technically, you know, there is footage already, but T1 scouted the rest of this team by themselves, and here they are back at Worlds.
Ooh, Faker did not scout out this play coming out from 100 Thieves, though.
Good stun, good damage. Flash, maybe to safety. Not closers here. Big shutdown of the Trundles. Ready to siege yet another turret. Nearly crushing that 10,000 gold difference. Someday, nearly another turret. He's dead to this. Ulti, big stun, big heal. Gore Drinker, not gonna be enough. Kana went for early Grievous Wounds that made the difference and down.
Finals this year. And did push him pretty hard. 100 Thieves trying to contest here.
Close
but too
He gets a Baron, but is it going to be much more? A clutch smite to be sure. However, it's still one kill picked up. Faker finds a tidal wave. Kana sidesteps and doesn't find his way in for a slicing maelstrom. So
look forward just kind of weaving in and out of these fights, trying to hit a chain and set something up. But I don't really think they should have the opportunity, but I look wrong.
Cannot get over the wall, so they're gonna have a hard time joining Someday here. Wants to stun Owner. Decent damage. Stopwatch burn Faker here, but not a lot of damage out of him either. Owner gonna get back to safety to the rubble of his turret.
As here comes Kennen.
And Kennen, yes, Someday has to mark it, but he can't find the stun. The flash is too soon. Kana plays it beautifully, kills off two, and Someday is gonna be next. Gets a heal, it's not gonna matter. And it's time for T1 to march into the 100 Thieves base.
For Celsius gained this gold lead.
Decent damage on a carry. They find one for nothing. Kana gets a stun onto the two frontliners as it is gonna be Trundle dropping. It's a 4v4 doable. Gimayushi, he gale forces forwards and just finds himself the kill as the FBI tried to open up but gets shut down instead. Huhi gonna drop, and Faker finds the kill onto Huhi. It's time to get away from this one. It's time for T1 to march straight down the mid lane.
You know, 100 Thieves did everything they did with so much confidence. I kept believing they could bring it back, but T1 are just too far ahead. They have the death timers. They're going to be able to just push into the base and look for the close.
Somehow a 2v4 defense has to happen as Caria respawns inside the fountain. The stun of Abenaga. Faker a little bit low. Owner in there as well. Doesn't quite find the kill, but Gumayushi going to find himself the turret. And now the Nexus is open. The Nexus will drop. And T1 in under 30 minutes take down their primary competition and are in control of second.